Hello everyone, this is Teo. I'm the CEO of Espressif Systems. Welcome to the Espressif Developers Conference 2024. Let me update you on the latest development in Espressif. First of all, we have had a great start this year. In the first half of 2024, we have had about 40% revenue growth year over year. And as you know, since Espressif is totally in the AIoT domain, this means that our customers who are working on AIoT are also doing fantastic. Our growth is driven mainly by many of the new applications that now connect to the internet to provide more value-added services to the end users. This includes applications like solar panels, electric chargers, toothbrushes, low-power cameras, new drones like this one over here from M5 Stack. And yes, we did just acquire M5 Stack a couple of months ago. In case you're not familiar with them, they produce probably the best development kits for Espressif chips that are usually in the bento box styles. I have known the team from M5 Stack for almost 10 years, and we absolutely love the designs of the systems that they build. The boxes range from the tiny ones like this one here, which has got a digital crown that you can use to select menu items, and then you press to select the actual item. Or the bigger ones like this one, which is now attached to a power module, and outputs a variable voltage that we sometimes use to test our chips. So they are very useful, robust, and easily extensible. You can add sensors to them. And in the case of this drone, which is one of their new products, is also a lot of fun. M5 Stack is great for prototyping. It has a lot of great ideas about how ESP chips can be used to build applications. And in some cases, customers have even built actual products with M5 Stack devices. So do drop by their website, as it might give you some new inspiration or ideas. Now about the chips. ESP32P4 and ESP32S3 continue to address rich HMI use cases through LVGL and other third-party graphics libraries that are optimized for these SoCs. On the IoT security front, new security certifications and standards are becoming applicable worldwide. Our products and solutions are ready to address these emerging requirements. We continue to take an open approach towards security and provide affordable security with our innovative hardware and security features. ESP IDF now supports the Trusted Execution Environment, or TEE, on ESP32C6. This capability will be available on ESP32C5 and other SoCs as soon as they're available. So we also see increased adoption of the Matter protocol, and we continue to provide the most comprehensive solution for Matter. The recent release of Matter specification adds support for new device types, including kitchen appliances, water management, energy management, and EV chargers. Espressif supports all of them through our ESP Matter SDK and solutions like ESP Zero Code, Alexa Connect Kit, AWS IoT Express Link, and other Matter connectivity modules. For your information, ESP Zero Code now has more than 15,000 users that have created their own Matter product configurations. Espressif is now also an open product attestation authority. This allows us to be even more flexible in providing DAC certificate provisioning for in-field devices and enabling customer factories. So we help you navigate this complicated process of certifying and bringing your Matter product to the market. ESP Rainmaker now supports ESP SoC-based thread border routers and Matter controllers natively. This allows customers to build their complete Matter ecosystem. Complementary to this, customers can now build thread-based devices that are directly connected to ESP Rainmaker. There are several other key developments on the ESP Rainmaker side. It now offers an out-of-the-box solution for electric vehicle chargers through the standard OCPP protocol, as well as home energy management devices. With the camera capabilities of ESP32P4, ESP Rainmaker is now getting ready to support camera-based devices, and we already have WebRTC and Amazon KVS support on ESP32P4. ESP Rainmaker is now also available in the China region. I also often get asked a lot when we should use Wi-Fi 6 and when Wi-Fi 4 would do. Well, if you were to be doing a toothbrush and cost sensitive, and the toothbrush connects to the internet only a couple of times a day, ESP32C2 and ESP32C3, which are very low cost Wi-Fi chips, would probably do. But if you have an application which is in an environment with like sharing the bandwidth with hundreds of IoT devices and is more data intensive and power sensitive, you'll probably be better off with Wi-Fi 6 because of the following reasons. The Wi-Fi 6 standard comes with a couple of new protocols such as TWT, Target Wait Time, OFDMA, Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiple Access, and MU-MIMO, which is Multiple User, Multiple Input, Multiple Output technologies. These allow the devices to be more efficient both in terms of bandwidth and power. So in short, you can support more devices, IoT devices with Wi-Fi 6, with better power sense efficiency. So we are seeing right now ESP32C6 being deployed in low power applications where it spends most of its time in a sleep mode using TWT and also in cameras, which streams short bursts of data to the router periodically. Lastly, I hope you have a great time with the presentations in the Developers Conference. We at Espressif remain on our mission to enable our customers and to help you to build the best IoT applications in the shortest time with minimal effort. In short, we help ensure that you can focus on innovation and build the best applications. Thank you.